Hey y'all, it's Pier Elizabeth and welcome back to my channel. If you guys didn't already see from the title, today I'm gonna be telling y'all about my freshman experience at the illustrious Clark Atlanta University. Oh, period. So don't let nobody tell you otherwise.
Gotta smoke one before I get on this one. Shawty ice cold, she still phone a nigga. Buy me a parking float like the real. I shoot shots like Reggie Miller. Girl, you look so familiar. She a bad one, she love Christian. She love diamonds, pay attention. Can I have you? Girl, I want you. Girl, I need you.
I'm just gonna like just be basically sharing like my overall experience as a freshman, my overall freshman experience at Clark Atlanta. I mean, I'm just gonna try to get to, you know, I'm gonna try to cover all the details, but I will make other videos, like for instance, like an advice video, how to get into Clark video, how to get into a bunch of HBCUs, because honestly, I got into a lot, but Clark is the one that I chose, and I did it at an affordable price, because you know, applying for college and stuff, it can be really expensive. But anyway, that's gonna be like another video, but this video is just gonna be solely based off of my experience only. So let's go ahead and get into it, y'all. The first thing that I'm gonna cover is, I'm just gonna start like from the very beginning. So when I realized that I wanted to go to Clark, like when I came to the conclusion, like this is the school that I'm gonna go to, all that stuff, I started joining group chats. So how do you join group chats? Basically, I was just going like, I was just on social media and I was looking up like my classes. Well, technically my class is 22 because that's what I'm gonna be graduating, but really, my class is 23. I don't know if that's gonna make sense or not. My graduating class technically is 22. That's when I'll be graduating because I didn't do enrollment, but I came in with class of 23. So that's who I wanted to make friends with, mostly because we were all gonna be freshmen. So I went on social media and stuff and I ran into this page. I forget what it's called, but it was like CAU 23 or something like that, which was like the class that, I don't know, somebody made a page or something and they had the GroupMe link in there, so I pressed it and I joined it. And when I joined it, it turns out like they made like a whole bunch of other group chats from people in the GroupMe, like personal group chat, like iMessage group chats. And so I swear to you, I was in like 20 group chats. Like I only talked in like two of them though. Sometimes I'm not really good with the group chats, but honestly, that's how, like, when I went to NSO, which is like new student orientation before school starts, like I knew a lot of people already because I had did the group chat, and when I got to school, actually got to school, I knew a lot of people too because I was in the group chat. So it was kind of convenient. Like, I suggest you get in the group chat. It can be a little messy. That's gonna be some story times because baby. So I got into a bunch of group chats and I was just talking to people here and there. Like I said, I was really only talked in two group chats. One of them actually still, I'm a sophomore now, technically a junior, whatever, but I still talk to those people every day. Like, so I already had kind of like my group of friends and stuff when I got to school. I'm no longer friends with like half of those people, well, really like three of those people, but it's okay. Housing. Let's get into housing. So first things first, you don't get to pick your housing, which sucks. You don't get to pick it though. So for all males, because the male ratio and female ratio are just like so off, like there's way more females at Clark compared to men, so all the freshman boys, they have to stay in this one dorm, Beckwith, aka Beck Shenane. And then if you're a girl, you can get into the traditionals, which is Pfeiffer, Holmes, Myrner. I think it's only three. I don't know, I didn't stay in a traditional, but I think it's only three. Those are the only ones I can think of. And then you could also stay in the suites. There's suites 100 and there's suites 200. I got into suites 100, y'all. That's the best one, if you ask me, suites 100. And then I stayed on the first floor, which was very convenient for me. I like staying on the first floor. Everybody, that wasn't like their thing, but I like staying on the first floor. My room number, since I don't stay there and will not stay there again, was 110A. And it was crazy. because when I used to do this thing called Camp Kizzy with Keisha Knight Pulliam, the actress, she used to be on the Cosby Show. She played Ruby, something like that. And like, she had us stay in Clark's campus or whatever for one of the summers that she had us. And it was crazy because that's the room that I got. It was kind of like foreshadowing my life, like. And once in A, I liked that room a lot because I felt like, for me, a type of person that leaves very late to get to class and stuff, and leaves late for like everything, it was just really convenient because I could just run out. Like, the front door is like right there. When you're trying to avoid people, it's really convenient as well because I could just run to my room and I don't have to talk to nobody. I don't really have to see nobody, even though I'm a social person, but sometimes I just didn't want to deal with people. And they just didn't need to know I was in my room, because if they did, they would be trying to come in there. Like, when my friends would be like, oh, I'm outside or something like that, I could just, I'm like there like that. Like, I didn't have to rush because I don't have to take the elevator, which, by the way, literally never worked. The elevator never worked. And I got stuck on it trying to visit one of my friend's room, trying to come back from one of my friend's room. And I got stuck in there and I was in there for like 30 minutes and it was hot. It was hot. And my phone was on 3%. Anyway, I'm trying to add some clips and stuff of like how my room looked. Okay, so there's two sides of the room. And it's like, so there's a 110A. I'm just giving y'all an example with my room number. So it's 110A and there's a 110B. So I stayed on 110A, which was like on the left side, and then 110B was on the right side. So the things that divide the rooms up is the bathroom. The bathroom's in the middle. Basically, it's just a shower and a toilet. Shower and a toilet. On my side of the room, well, on both sides of the room, but I'm just gonna talk about mine, is 1 and 2. There's a 1 and 2. So you'll get assigned room 1 or room 2. I think I have room 1. But I had the room where all my stuff was like in my space. The other room, the other side next to me, my roommate's side, she was like, her desk was outside of her room. So she had her bed and everything in her room, but her desk was outside of the room. Personally, I feel like it was smaller on that side. So I'm glad that I got the side that I got. Also, like, we don't have doors to separate me and my roommate's side. We only have doors to separate my suite mate's side, which was 110B. So I used a curtain. Most people use a curtain. I closed that thing like it was a door and I didn't care. Now, the way I said that might have sounded like I had beef with my roommate. My roommate, I didn't have beef with her. I really didn't. She was a junior and I was a freshman. Now, at first, I didn't have a roommate and I was very happy about that. But then she came and I was thinking, okay, oh, a junior, like, she can be like my big sister. She can like give me advice and, you know, whatever. No, she was not trying to talk to me. She was not trying to talk to me at all. She was not trying to deal with me. She did what she did. I did what I did. But I did attempted to try to be friends with her. We were cordial. Like I said, it was no beef. Like, every now and then, like, she would try to do my makeup or try to do my hair or something, and I would just let her, because I can't lie, she did makeup pretty decent. Like, she did. Or like, if my mom made me some food or something, I would be like, do you want some, and share it with her. But like, talking all the time, no. There would be some times where we both would just be in the room and just like, I would just close my curtain. If you don't want to talk to me, then that's fine. But anyway, but my roommate, she was pretty cool though. Like, you're not gonna be best friends with your roommate. Well, you might be best friends with your roommate, but most of the time, you're not gonna be best friends with your roommate. Cause I know when I first came to school, me and my, like I said, I didn't have a roommate at first, but I had suite mates. And me and my suite mates, we would be talking and chilling and everything all the time, like, at first. And then I don't know what happened, but they just stopped talking to each other. So I stopped going over there because it was awkward. So I just stopped going over there. But I mean, you have to think about it. When you live with somebody, like, it's hard to live with them and be friends with them sometimes. Like, you hanging out all day long, that can be very stressful. That can be very annoying. But anyway, like I said, my roommate was pretty cool, but The only thing I didn't like about my roommate was she was kind of messy. Like, I am a clean, I'm not a clean freak, but I'm very clean. Like, my room was always clean before I left my room every morning for class. My bed was made up. My room was clean because at the end of the day, it's a small space. Like, it's bigger than traditional, but it's small. Like, it doesn't take a lot to get messy. It doesn't take a lot for your room to be messy because it's a small space. So my room was always clean. Also, like, I never knew when somebody was gonna come over. When I say people would just knock knock, it's me, and come in my room, like, that's literally what they would do. And so it's gonna be clean. It was always clean. But my roommate, though, no, she did not care. She did not care. Her room was never clean, and she didn't have a curtain. So when you first walked in, all you seen was the mess. The sink, my side of the sink will be clean. Nothing will be on there because I don't like clutter. Her side will be full of hair products and whatever else, makeup and all that stuff. And I just like, and it's like, I would clean it for her and it was still like, she didn't care. She did not care. And then she would start putting her stuff on my side and I would kindly move it back. Like, that was literally my only issue with her, is the fact that she just wasn't that clean. I'm not about to sit here and say she was dirty, but she just was messy. And I don't like messy. I don't like that. Okay. This is why I probably won't be staying on campus ever again, because I don't like having roommates and stuff. Like, I don't like that. I like living by myself. Oh my gosh, I just thought of something. With my roommate, another thing that I really didn't like about my roommate is that she had these friends that were, first of all, loud. So loud for no reason. Would literally come in the room yelling. And like, most of the time I would be taking a nap or something and they would just come in the room yelling. But like, another thing that I really, really didn't like. This is what I really, really didn't like. She would, like, I would come in from class. I would come in from wherever I was at, because I can't even say that I was going to class. I don't know. I would come in where, I mean, I would come in my room or whatever, and she wouldn't be in there, but would tell me why her friends was in there. And they would be, like, laying on the bed, like, on her bed, just sleep. Like, are you my roommate? Or is that girl my roommate? I don't know, because she's not here ever. You're here. And she's not. I thought that was really weird. Like, me come, like, she didn't text me like, hey, my friends are coming over. I think that's just roommate etiquette. Like, hey, I'm about to have company. I just wanted you to know. But I think that is really weird that she wouldn't, first of all, she wouldn't tell me. Second of all, it's like, you're not even in there. You just left them in there with, like I said, I didn't have a door. So, like, all my stuff is out. I'm not saying that they would have stolen anything or anything, but it's like, still, this is not just your room. This is my room too. So I would like to know if you're going to be leaving random people in my room when I'm not there. That's all I'm saying. That's roommate etiquette. If you have a roommate, inform them of when you're having company. Period. Because that's roommate etiquette. As far as RAs, like, I'm going to be honest with you. I was doing everything in my room also. Like, they tell you don't bring a hot plate. They tell you don't do a bunch of stuff. And I really don't know. I really wasn't in my room like that. But when I was in my room, I was cooking in my room, because that cat food, baby, it's not good. It's not good. Honestly, I was eating out most of the time. But when I, second semester, when I started running out of money, then I started to cook my own food. Me and my friends started bringing hot plates and pans and buying meat and making tacos and stuff, because nobody wants to eat that cat food. Nobody wants to eat that. Like I said, I stayed on the first floor. So there was a bunch of RAs on the first floor. Nobody ever said anything to me. I know you could smell the food. I know, like, I didn't really try to hide it much, but nobody ever said anything to me. So I kept doing it. But don't get caught, because if you get caught, you will get fined. Some people say, okay, get really close to your RAs. I didn't get close to my RAs. They weren't that nice to me. So I tried to. They were kind of rude. So I didn't really talk to them. It's not hard to not get caught. It's not hard to not get caught. I don't feel like you have to make friends with them unless you just really, really want to be friends with them. But you don't have to. Like, I know that's like something that a lot of people say, oh, you have to be friends with your RA so that you can get away. No, you don't. Because I didn't. I tried. They weren't nice. So, I mean, I'm not going to beg you to be my friend. Another thing about the suites is when you walk in there, it literally smells like weed. Off rip. That's the one thing they never say anything to you about if you're smoking. One, because they can't figure out what room is coming from. Two, I don't really know why they don't say anything, but they don't. They don't say anything about smoking. That's like the one thing they won't say anything to you about. Unless you set off the fire alarm, and then they're gonna be mad because we all have to walk out and it's just like a whole thing. But again, they still won't know where it came from, so you won't get in trouble. A lot of people would like come to the suites to smoke. But our RAs, though, all in all, they were pretty lenient compared to like the traditionals. The traditionals couldn't do nothing. I couldn't even go visit my friends in traditionals. They were like, you don't live here, you gotta go. I was like, excuse me? In the suites, they don't care. You just have to be a girl. If you're a girl, you can walk in. Like, all my Spelman friends and stuff, they would just walk in and walk to my room like nothing. But traditionals, no. I go to Clark and I'm a girl and I couldn't get in there. So, visitation hours, hit that real quick. Visitation was from 6 to 12. And you can only bring in two guys or two people. You can only bring in two people. But like I said, if you were a girl, you could just walk in. So it's no need to check them in and use your one of your people. So really, I'm just saying you can only check in two guys. They had to have their ID, either their school ID or their regular ID. And they had to give it to you. I mean, give it to the RA up front. You had to give them yours, sign them in, and then you can go do whatever you're gonna do. And then at 12 o'clock, you need to be back or they're gonna try to find you. I don't know anybody that got fined, but that's what they said. They said they will fine you. I don't know. I don't know. Next is boys, because I know that's what you guys want to know about. Boys. First of all, this was told to me. Don't try to get into don't come into college thinking that you're going to get into a relationship, because chances are you're not. I'm not saying that people like don't get into relationships when they're in college, but most of the time, no. And this is, and I'm gonna tell you all what my guy friends told me. We're young, nobody's trying to get into a relationship right now. Da, 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 da. Like, that's what they say. Like, they really like be on their future, like, they be like looking up the future. Like, they really admire that man, Future and NBA Youngboy. If that's what you want in your life, then go for it, sis. Go for it, sis. If you're here for a good time, not a long time, go for it. But don't think that you're going to get in a relationship, because you probably won't. And most of the guys, most of them will tell you, like, up front, like, that's not what I want. I want a yeah, and that's it. That's, like, you know what they want. And most of the time, they'll tell you that, but I don't know. Like, okay, so I'm just going to compare, Clark guys and Morehouse guys. I did not talk to Clark guys. Not because I had a problem with them, just because there wasn't that many. And it seemed like the one guy that I was going to give a chance was literally talking to my roommate. I mean, my sweet mate. And saying all types of stuff to her. And I was like, whoa, you can have him. Because no, I'm not sharing. I mostly talked to Morehouse guys. Most of my friends were Morehouse guys. Any guy that I actually talked to was, they went somewhere else. So like, there just wasn't that many Clark guys. Like, I literally have like two, maybe three friends that are boys at Clark. Like three. Like I said, there's not that many, so they all stay in like one dorm. It's like, I don't know. They just, I don't know. I don't know why. I just wasn't friends with them because I just didn't know them. I didn't see them. I don't know. But that's like, I feel like my experience was a little bit different because girls at Clark, they had like a bunch of guy friends at Clark. I didn't, like, I was never in Beckwith ever. Ever. I went in there twice. Both to see my friend. That's it. I honestly, I didn't really like it in there. It didn't look as nice as the suites. It just looked really not cute. But they had a kitchen though, and we didn't have a kitchen, so I don't understand what that was, that situation was about. But yeah, some people say that Clark guys are better because they're nicer and all that stuff. I wouldn't know because I didn't even know any. So I didn't really know any to say. But I knew a lot of Morehouse guys. Like, I have like 3 Morehouse brothers, and in my opinion, they're great to me. Not all of them, but my Morehouse brothers, great. A1. If I want some food, they gonna give me some food. If I want to talk, they'll listen. Like, I don't know, they're just really good friends. Like, they're really, really good friends. Talking wise, I mean, obviously I'm single, so it didn't really go well. But most of them, like, I'm still cool with them. It's just, we just didn't go anywhere. Reason why I didn't work out with me is because they didn't want a relationship. They wanted to just be like friends with benefits, and I don't want that. But and that kind of like proves my point as to what I was saying earlier, is that they just don't come to most of them don't come to college looking for that. They're just looking for a good time. Like, that's literally the best way I can describe it. So just please don't think that this is gonna be like a drum line, because that ain't this and this not that. Okay, next I'm gonna just talk about friends. Like, most of my friends actually did not go to Clark. Like, this is where my story is kind of different from like other people's story that, you know, tell their experience, because like I said, I didn't really talk to any Clark guys, but I also didn't really talk to many Clark girls. Like, I was mostly on Spelman and Morehouse's campus. I had my friends at Clark. I'm not saying I didn't talk to anybody. I was cordial with them. And I had, like 3 of my best friends, they go to Clark. So I was either with them all the time or I was with my Spelman friends. But there was no in-between. It was either those 3 or my Spelman friends. Period. And it's like, second semester, I started making more friends at Clark, but then like we got sent home because of COVID. So like I said, like, I was always at Morehouse and Spelman. That's pretty much where I stayed. Most people actually thought I went to Spelman, but I didn't. I would go to Clark, and yeah, I actually love my Spelhouse friends though. They're great. But so are my Clark ones. My Clark friends are great too. Making friends though, they're not hard. Like, most of my friends that I made though, I met them in group chats. Everyone you meet in a group chat, you're not gonna be friends with them afterwards, but some of them you will. But most of my friends, yep, I met them through group chats. We linked and we ended up you know, being cool after we meet. Because you're not gonna be cool with everybody after you meet. You're gonna be like, oh, they're weird, or oh, this, or oh, that. But my friends, yeah, most of them I met through group chat. Not hard to make friends. Literally, when I started making my new friends second semester before we got kicked off campus, I just put something on my Instagram story looking for new friends in the AUC or something. Do you want to be friends with me? Yes. Vote no if you don't. Nobody voted no. Okay, some people voted no, but they were my friends already. Like, they was just hating. But a lot of people said yeah, and then we started DMing each other, and we was like, oh yeah, we're gonna link after spring break. Nope. I played myself. We both played ourselves, because we didn't even come back after spring break. But my point is, I was gonna have a whole bunch of new friends lined up. So with that being said, it's not hard to make friends. You could literally say, hey, I like your shoes, what's your name? Like, literally, like, it's so simple. Like, it's literally that simple. You can join clubs, get to know people. I wasn't really a club person. I tried. They were all stupid to me. So I just stopped showing up to the meetings, and I wasted my money. But I still put them on my resume for sure. But I don't think it's anything wrong with having friends within the AUC. You literally have like 3 schools, 4 if you want to count Morris Brown. I didn't know anybody at Morris Brown though. They just got their accreditation back. So I guess there's going to be more students there. It might be actually more lit afterwards, you know, when we get back to school. I don't know. But just talking about Clark, Spelman, and Morehouse, like, you literally have 3 schools. for the most part, you guys do the same stuff. You have the same professors. You do activities, join clubs, all the same. So why not take advantage of that? Networking is like one of the most important things. Like, I almost like academics almost don't even matter. They don't matter as, okay, I'm not gonna say they don't matter. They matter, but they don't matter as much as networking, because networking is what's really gonna get you to where you wanna go. I'm gonna get into academics really quick. So I'm a mass media arts major. Mass media arts, there's nothing hard about that. Nothing hard about that at all. Do your work. It's not hard. I honestly, okay, virtually, they give you way more work than they give you when you're on campus. So it might be a little bit more work virtually at home until we get back. But when we were at school, I honestly don't even really remember doing work, like, because I really didn't. And I had all A's. Like, I'm telling you, it was easy. Nothing was hard about it at all. So don't be stressed out. If you're another major, I can't speak for you. I can only speak for mass media arts. And what's even better is I can really tell you guys, like, yeah, I'm a sophomore, but I'm taking junior classes right now. Like I said, I'll be graduating next year. But so when I was a freshman, I wasn't taking freshman classes, which freshman classes are just like the basic classes, like math, science, you know, all that stuff. I didn't take that stuff. Really, I took two, bio and pre-calculus. Pre-calculus was hard, but it was definitely my professor's fault. But bio was super easy. Like, it's all really about your professors for the basic classes, but I can only speak for two basic classes because after that I was into my major. And so now I'm taking junior class, and I can tell you, it doesn't do anything but get easier. The teachers don't do anything but get lazy. That's one of the issues that some people were talking about. They're like, they don't feel like they're challenged at Clark. It really depends on what you're looking for and like what you want. Personally, I don't necessarily feel challenged, but I don't think that it should be so hard to where you can't pass your classes. So I'm okay with that. That networking is everything. They tell you, they'll be like, oh yeah, go to the mass media arts building all the time. Stay in the mass media arts building because that's where you're gonna get your internships. You have to like kiss people's butts and stuff like that. No, you don't listen to them. Don't listen to them, because I was never in the mass media arts department unless I had a class in there. That was the only time I was in there. And guess what? Your girl got two internships. All you have to do is you have to go out and seek it for yourself, because it's not going to be handed to you. It's not going to be given to you. And it is handed to some people at other schools, and it is given to people at other schools, but it will not be given or handed out to you. You have to go find your internships yourself. But it's not impossible, and it's not hard or anything like that. Like, being nice to people honestly goes a long way, because that's pretty much how I got mine. I was just nice to people, and people wanted to see me do well, I guess. And so they'll be like, oh, did you hear about this internship? I feel like it would be good for you. And then I'll be like, oh no, I didn't, but thanks for telling me. It wasn't professors either, it was like students. Either that, or when you hear about something, don't be afraid to just go out there and just try it, because that's what I did. And I got an internship that I didn't even think that I was gonna get at all. I had literally no experience in it or anything, and I got it, and it looks great on my resume now. So definitely go out and do that. But academic wise, it's not hard. In my next video, because I don't want to do too much in the video because I already feel like it's too long, but in my next video I'm going to give you guys like advice. I do not think that certain majors, if you're majoring in a certain thing, I don't think Clark is a school for you, because no. But I'm gonna get into that in another video. Oh, did I miss homecoming? I'm gonna talk about homecoming really quick. Homecoming was lit, baby, lit. I was having so much fun on homecoming. I went to Spellhouse's homecoming, which is Spellman and Morehouse, and I went to Clark's homecoming, and both of them was fun. I will say Spellhouse was more fun, but it's only because they didn't have like the little they had pretty much all concerts, but like Clark, they had like little comedy night and all that stuff, and I personally felt like that was wasting my money, only because like these are people I have class with, like this is what we do in class. I don't want to pay for it, but I did though, because I wanted the experience. And like the concert though, by far Clark's concert was way better. Like, we had the baby and all that stuff, way better than Spark House, because I got story time for the Spark House one. Anyway, I feel like I feel like I covered everything that I wanted to cover. Like I said, by the end of the school year, well, when we got kicked off, I was having a great time. I liked school. All my friends was great. Everything was great until we left school. You know, now it's different. If you guys have any questions or anything about Clark or just school in general, like, you can just leave it in the comments down below or whatever, like DM me or whatever, and I'm gonna answer them in my advice video. And I have a lot of story time and stuff about school. Like, I was only there for like a semester and a half, but so much happened in the semester and a half. Like, so much happened. So I have a lot of like story time and stuff, but I just wanted to give you guys like a general idea of how my freshman year was. Of course, there were some ups and downs. It wasn't perfect all the time, but it wasn't bad though. Like, there were some times I was like, I'm gonna drop out. Not drop out, but I'm about to transfer school because no, because they're getting on my nerves and all that stuff. But it's like, everything's not gonna be perfect. You have to get used to like being away from home and all that stuff. Fortunately for me, I'm from Atlanta, so my parents stay like 30 minutes away. So when I needed something, I could just call my parents. Hey, can you bring me some food? Or hey, can't you come give me some money? Or hey, some, you know, whatever. And I had like most, like, not even my immediate family. I have my grandparents are here, my aunts, uncle, they're all here. So it was like, that was convenient for me, but I know that's not for everybody. So some people's mental health was kind of like trash at first because they were just, you know, trying to get used to a time at school. I loved it. I definitely recommend Clark, only if you have study major. That's why it's gonna be in my next video. As a mass media arts major, I loved it, and I think it's great, and I think it's just a lot of opportunities within the AUC alone, because like I said, I don't think you should just take advantage of only Clark stuff. Not when you have three schools there that are willing to help you. No. So a lot of opportunities, a lot of stuff. Like I said, be a go-getter and all that stuff, and you'll get what you want pretty much. I mean, yeah, so I had a great time. Love it. I cannot wait till we go back, even though I know it's not gonna be the same, which sucks. I know it's not gonna be the same for it probably won't be the same until after I graduate. It's unfortunate, but I had a good time for my little semester and a half, I guess. But yeah, thank you for watching my video. Look forward to more videos, definitely more videos about Clark is coming up, or just my experience or story times or whatever, because I have a lot. Like, comment, subscribe, follow me on social media. It's all gonna be in the link down below. And see you in my next one, next video. Bye.